Hi everyone. In today's video, we're going to talk about file I/O within Java. File I/O is just a fancy way of saying file input output. And what that means is we're talking about reading and writing to files, where all that a file is something that holds data. A file can contain data that encodes binary, so zeros and ones. It can contain text, or it can contain images or other random data formats that your software might need to use. In today's video, I want to talk about a few ways that you can read and write to a text file within Java. Let's go ahead and pull up IntelliJ and take a look. Today's project we'll call file.io. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about how you write to a file. So I'm going to go over two different ways that you can write to a file. The first way is with a file writer. Now you'll notice here that it says it doesn't know what constructor file writer is without any parameters in here. So if you hover over this, it gives you a list of the different options. I'm going to go ahead and just pick this first one here, and I am going to pass in a string as the file name that I want to write to. So in this case, I want the name of my file to be output.txt. So I still have an error here. Let's go ahead and hover over this and see what the IDE is saying. It says unhandled exception Java IO IO exception. So one thing we haven't talked about too much with different types of exceptions is you have checked and unchecked exceptions. So any sort of input output or IO exception, that would be considered a checked exception. And what that means is that at compile time, you need to make sure that you can handle an exception in some way in your code. Whereas with an unchecked exception, that would be something that you can encounter at runtime. So this is a checked exception. So now we have two options. We can either wrap this code with a try catch block, or we can be lazy, which is what I'm going to do in this case. And we can just add a throws clause in our main method. And I could say throws IO exception. And this would work after I import it. And now the next thing you got to make sure you do is whenever you're dealing with a file writer or really much of any sort of IO type writer, reader, anything like that, you've got to make sure that it's closed. And what that close method does is it basically makes sure that everything gets into a good state after you're done with any sort of file IO. Because file IO touches other things on the system that are outside of your direct program, you gotta make sure that your program leaves everything in a good state. So closing your IO resources is always a good practice. So now that we've constructed our writer and we're closing it, let's go ahead and actually put something into our file. You can use the write method to do that, and you can pass in a string so that you're writing text. So this is text in a file. And now if I run this code, you'll notice that there's no output here. All it says is that our program exited correctly. But then over here on the left, we have an output txt that wasn't here previously. If I open this up, I can see this is the file that was generated. Sweet. Let's go ahead and update this file and we'll write another line to it. So if I want to write another line, I should be able to do something like this, right? And then in this line, I want to say another line. Let's go ahead and see what this does. All right, so we should take two notes here. The first thing is output.txt was created by our program the first time we ran this. The second time we ran this, what it actually does is it completely overwrites what was there and it puts in the content that the program wants. So be very careful whenever you are writing to files that you make sure that the file either doesn't exist or you're okay with it getting overwritten. Second point is that it says this is text in a file, and then I don't have any sort of new line going on here. It just continues on. So there are a few ways to fix that. One you'll see used quite often is that people will throw a backslash n at the end of a write method like this. This will work, and I'll demonstrate that it works. So we can see it works, but there's a little bit of a problem here, and that is that this is not platform independent code. One of the great things about Java is that you can run your Java program on any platform that has a Java runtime environment installed on it. So what we want to do is we want to make sure that anytime we're doing something, we make it platform independent as much as possible. This is specifically the new line ending used for Unix type systems, and this backslash n is called a line feed. On Windows, you have to also do a carriage return or a backslash R. So on Windows, you have a carriage return and then a line feed, whereas on Unix-based systems, you only have a line feed. So I could go ahead and I could write some code that looks at which operating system I'm running on and decide which one to use. Let's not do that. Let's use what Java already has built in for us. And that is system.lineSeparator. And I'll show you when we run this code, the output's the same, but this code's a lot safer. And as you can see, our output hasn't changed and we're good to go here. So that's the first way that you write to the file. The second way I'm going to show is I'm going to wrap this file writer with a buffered writer. The difference is that a buffered writer adds a few additional convenience methods, and it also is more efficient when you need to do a larger file. So in this case, I'm going to change this to buffered writer. And then we're going to say this equals new buffered writer. And a buffered writer can take a file reader in its constructor. So really not much has to actually change here. And as we'll see, if I run this code, and we can see that our output's the same. So you might be thinking, okay, then why do you have to even have this second method? Well, the second method for doing it here, it has different use cases. Let's say that you wanted to write a giant file and you want to do batch writes. The performance of your program will typically be better with a buffered writer rather than just a file writer. So it kind of comes down to the particular use case. In our case, it doesn't make a huge difference. Another thing that the buffered writer does get for you is you can do writer.newline, and that replaces the need to call out the system line separator here. And I'll demonstrate that working. And we can see that generates the same output. Sweet. One other thing I want to touch on is that if you wanted to manage having to call these close methods, there's a nice way to do that that is recommended when you're using Java 7 or later, and that is using something called try with resources. And that is where you wrap a resource that gets closed inside of a try statement. And then what you do is you move everything that that resource needs to do within your try statement, and then you don't need to call close, because close automatically gets called when you leave the scope of your try statement here. And you might think this is a little odd syntax, because typically when you have a try, you have a catch or a finally. In this case, you don't need a catch or a finally, because the only thing that you're trying to do is automatically close your resource when you know you're done with it. So try with resources is really useful, and I like to use it a lot in my code. So now that we talked about writing to a file, let's talk about reading from a file. Like with writing, I'm going to give two different examples. The first example, I'm going to use a buffered reader. And just like the buffered reader, I'm going to, instead of using a file writer, I'm going to use a file reader. And then in this case, I'm going to go ahead and have my file reader read the same file that we just generated with output.txt. And like before, let's go ahead and wrap this in a try with resources statement so we don't have to worry about forgetting to call close on our resource. And reading from a file is actually quite easy. All you have to do is reader.readline, and this returns a string, which is a line of your file. So let's go ahead and just print this out for now and see what this looks like. All right, so as we can see, we get the first line of our file, and if I look at what the output.txt file looks like, we're only getting that first line. We're not getting this second line, which says another line in it. So if we want to read the entire file, we basically need to iterate over the reader until the reader doesn't have anything left to give us. And reader.readline will give us a value of null when it's done. I'll go ahead and just demonstrate that here. So if I call this over and over again, we see what this prints out. You can see that we get the file we want, and then we start getting nulls after that. So what we need to do is we need to write a loop that continues to iterate over the output of reader.readline until we hit a value of null. Let's go ahead and do that quick. All right, so this is what you see people typically write when they're looping over a file. They declare a line variable, and then what they do is they set the line variable equal to the reader's current readline method output, and then they check to see if this whole value is null or not. If it is, then you break out of the while loop. If it's not, you print out the value of the line variable. Another way you can do this is you could convert this into a for loop if you wanted to. This will result in the same output. I have a slight preference for this version because it's a little more condensed and I don't have to have a line variable outside of the scope of my while loop, and I've got everything contained in my for loop, but that's just my preference. as we can see, we get the contents of the file that we care about, not all of those null statements there at the end. So I promised that I was going to talk about multiple ways that you can read and write from a file. So now I'm going to talk about another way that you can read from a file. The second way I'm going to talk about is using something we've used previously, and that's using the scanner class. So I'm going to say scanner. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and scan over a file object. And I have to import some things here. And now with the scanner, I'm going to go ahead and modify my loop here a little bit. What I'll do in this case is I'll say while my reader dot has next line, that's a nice method that scanner provides for you. What I will do is I will say reader dot next line. And I will print this out like we were previously. And I'm going to go ahead and tweak my output.txt file a little bit just to show that we're actually changing it. And I'm going to run the code. You can see that we are reading from the new file because it has the extra characters here at the end. And if we look here, we see we have the new characters there at the end. And lastly, to close out, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of a bonus. Java 7 added some nice convenience methods in a new java.nio package. And one of the things that it does is it simplifies some file IO depending on the particular use case. So I'm going to go ahead and convert what I just did into a single line of code. I'm going to do files.readstring paths.get output.txt. And voila, we can see that with a single line of code, we get the same result that we did previously. Cool, right? I do caution you to not always use this method because this method basically loads the entire file into a single string. So the old methods still have good purpose and you might want to use them in certain cases. Or you might want to use other things within the files class. Just go ahead and look at the Java IO documentation. There's a whole lot out there, and it's really useful for determining a specific thing that you're looking to do. And that was an introductory tutorial on some Java file IO with reading and writing to files. I hope you found this video helpful. I know when I first was learning to code, I thought file IO was really confusing. So hopefully this helps some of you out there. If you enjoyed watching this video, please do give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching today's video. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.